Hello, Chris Menard here. I have a great video for you in Excel. If you're an Excel user, you're going to probably use this the rest of your life. It is how to use Sparklines in Excel, and I'm actually looking at some financial data first to do this. I'm on the Wall Street Journal's market report. I've got a company pulled up. The year 2017 is over here, and we move over to the left to 2021. And here you go right here with they're tracking their revenue. Here is their cost of goods sold. So it doesn't matter what you want to track as long as it's something numeric. You can make these sparklines in Excel. So let me pop over to Excel. I have Excel running. Notice I've got the year 2022 to 2017. I don't have any data in here. So just to show you this. One of my favorite functions is the RAND between. I'm gonna put in numbers between 1,000 and 5,000. Control enter, perfect. I got some numbers in here. I'm just gonna copy and paste values. So there are my numbers. Before I make my sparklines, it's basically a mini chart for each row of data. So row 2 is gonna have a chart. Row 3 is gonna have a chart. I would probably give myself a little bit of height room on my rows just to make this look better. There we go. I'm gonna call this chart. Insert tab. When you go to the insert tab, you have a group called sparklines. Inside of sparklines, I'm gonna do a column sparkline. What is my data range? My data range is right here. The location range is where do I want to put that sparkline chart. Hit OK. And there I go right there. If you notice a huge jump because I went from 2942 to that. Just to show you this, I make that number 5,000. That third column goes up 3,000, on and on. Crosshairs, pull down. Again, quick test. I've got cell C3. I want to make that 4,000. Watch that second column pop up there. So you can see why I added extra space. Now, here is what is interesting to me. I'm going to pop back over to the Wall Street Journal website. They did 5 years also, and they went with 2021, and then we go to the right to 2017. But their 5-year trend line that they did, they went from 2017, if you notice this, up to 2021, because 2017 the revenue was $20,452, the first column, and they went down to $13,857. That is that last column. So if you run into this back to Excel, here is the way to handle that. Sparkline is a contextual tab. Click out of it, you don't see it. Click back in it. There it is right here. Sparkline contextual tab. We want to go to the group axis, and we want to tell it to plot right to left. There you go. So if I change this number in cell B2 to the number 5,000, notice it is that last column. It just went up. One more test. If I change this number to the number 4,000, the first column should go up, and it does. So there is that trick right there. My point is this, what if you needed to chart each one of these companies? You'd end up with 5 charts. Would be a lot of work. You'd have to keep doing each one. Sparklines has you covered. One other cool feature in Sparklines, since I'm here, go to the contextual tab. Do you want to see the high point? Sure. Do you want to see the low point? Sure. So there you go. You can change the high point and low point very easy. Thank you. Have a great day. Oh, subscribe to my channel also. And ring the bell. Now have a great day. Thank you.